Of all of the praise that's been heaped on this extraordinary piece of film, what does today's honour mean to you personally?
I think we're very appreciative of Sky Arts giving us this, and particularly that Amar Asante has been here to give it, because she does terrific films, and so I'm really, we're both really pleased to say hello to Amar. And I've known Melvin many years. We go back a long way, so we share a few memories. So I think that means something. And we also would like to say that we do hope that Sky keeps its multiple ownership and doesn't get trapped into one owner, because I fear for its future if it does.
Talking about the future, obviously the process of making this film was a reflection of some of the most painful failings that currently plague our society. Do you feel more optimistic today than you were at the time you made this film?
Well, they're not failing so much from the government's point of view. I mean, from the government's point of view, this is a success, because it's created a climate of fear amongst people who are poor and who are vulnerable and who have no work. And that's their intention. So from their point of view, this spreading fear, is that's their method of disciplining people who are at their lowest ebb. But I do feel more optimistic, because I think the mood is changing. I think people are not prepared to put up with it any longer. I think the election results surprised quite a lot of people, and that's good. And I think there's a wind in the sails of the ship that once changed. So I think a cumbersome metaphor, but I think there will be change before long.
I guess, I know it's a slightly big and profound question, but do you think art, more so than any other tool, has the capacity to propel that change in a political, legal and social spectrum?
No, I think art can help to influence a public discourse, but what will make change is organisation. Political organisation, campaigning organisation, union organisation, so that people whose general discontent has a focus, and the focus can then move into political to change. There's a way in which they can see they can get success, and to do that you need organisation. One good organiser is worth 10 good artists.
One of my earliest memories of film was sitting down at home and watching Kez. Later on, I became acquainted with Kathy Come Home, and the direction I have gone in film is absolutely, without question, influenced by the existence of Ken Loach. I think he showed me, when I was too young to know that I might evolve to be a director, that it was important to tell films that had a point, that had a focus, that wanted to push change, push forward change, to bring evolution to our society that was for the benefit of all. And I think that there's no question that the films that I've made, only four of them, have been influenced by that stance.
All right, I'm Vincenzo Lamagna, and I'm the composer for Akram Khan's Giselle. And this, we collected the award for dance?
Yes.
Best dance.
How does it feel to be a South Bank Award winner?
It's a very nice feeling, I have to say. Yeah, very excited. Thank you, actually. How does it feel?
Well, I'm a principal ballet repetiteur, ballet master, with the English National Ballet, whom won the award for Akram Khan's Giselle. And I'm very happy for it. I'm very happy to collect that award for the company. We need young generation, particularly in the ballet and on and dance itself. Dance art itself, it's art form. So more people we have interested in art, I think it's better for any cases. Ballet makes people to have a self-discipline, discipline in general, and actually respect.
Can you talk about, for an audience, the experience they get from ballet that they perhaps don't from other forms of entertainment and even other forms of dance?
Well, it's probably it's better to talk to audience itself, but my experience is if the performance is really powerful and strong enough, it will stay in their hearts forever. So they will keep this in their mind for a long, long time, and that's what it makes the art, ballet as an art, is incredible. It's so rewarding, and anybody would like to try. It's actually incredible life as well when you're on top of the mountain.
My name is Sheku Kane Mason, and I've just collected the Breakthrough Artist Award.
Can you describe your feelings when your name was read out here today?
Amazing, because you know I've just been speaking to all of the other artists nominated in their respective categories and hearing their amazing stories, and so to be kind of recognised in the classical music category is such a wonderful feeling.
Of course, this is a celebration of all forms of art here today. What do you think classical music uniquely brings to that landscape?
For me, classical music has such a range of abilities. It can kind of transform your mood so effectively, and so in a time where it's often not as popular as other styles of music, I hope that this award and many other things will kind of bring it back into the popular kind of eye, I think.
That's hopefully a bright future for classical music. For you specifically, what are you moving on to at the moment?
So in September I'm studying at the Royal Academy of Music, so I'm really excited for that, and hopefully just continue to perform around this country and around the world, bringing music to everyone.
I'm Michael Morris, I'm the co-director of Art Angel, and we produced an unusual project in the empty cells and wings of Reading Prison with 23 artists, writers and readers.
Can you tell us a little bit about the genesis of that truly unique project?
Yeah, we were made aware that Reading Prison had been emptied out in 2013 by a colleague in the Fine Art Department of the University of Reading. And we were lucky enough to go in there shortly after it closed. And immediately we saw the potential for a project. And we took our cue from Oscar Wilde's interests in literature and the visual arts and invited some of the world's leading artists, some of the world's leading writers, and a group of 9 actors and performers to read every Sunday the great letter that Wilde wrote in his cell while imprisoned. All artists work under certain constraints of form, whether it's the form of the written word on a page or the form of a sculpture or an installation in a prison cell, as it was. So the constraints here were physical, small cells, wings that were of a certain width, which actually kind of gave the parameters for what was possible. Each of the artists, by and large, were creating new work in response not only to the physical situation of the prison, but to its historical and emotional reality, and in particular, filtered through Oscar Wilde's own experience.
What does it mean for you to be celebrated in an event like this that celebrates the whole range of arts, theatre, film, music, and where do you think visual art fits in that landscape?
Well, Art Angel has always worked across the arts. We've worked in performing arts, in film, in visual arts, in literature, and in digital arts. So for us, we feel at home in a multidisciplinary award ceremony, if we feel at home in an award ceremony at all.
Just sort of, to be honest, hoped it wouldn't win because we didn't want to get up
and embarrass ourselves, but, which we did a little bit.
No, sensation.
I guess it's an obvious question, but what does it mean for everyone involved in the show to not only be receiving award success, but particularly from an institution like the South Bank Show?
This whole ride has been totally overwhelming, and I think it's very easy to perceive something like this as an overnight success, but it has taken years and years of hard work to get to this point. So there's a bit of relief in there, but there's also a huge amount of pride for the collaborative effort that has come to this moment. It's very, very exciting for all of us. So. Yeah, go on, say something.
Say something. I've got nothing to say, as ever. It was amazing. Yeah, brilliant. She'd been working on this for a long time. She'd worked on it as a one-woman show as well, and I think because of that, it had this amazing sort of singularity of vision, and yeah, she's amazing. It's just done so well. It's so exciting.
I think fans, of course, are eager to know if we're going to get any more. Do you think that's a possibility?
hopefully. I mean, that's why tonight was sort of slightly scary, because it sort of felt like if it won us going up and accepting, it was kind of like our audition for the second series. But
hopefully she'll let us back.
Yeah, so maybe we'll be at it. I don't know.
Yeah, I think it's a case of if we can get everyone back together again, then it will happen. But she's a very busy lady, as we know. And so fingers crossed that we can create some more magic. We'll see.
I'm Richard Mantle, the General Director of Opera North, and we've collected the Opera Award.
Hi, I'm Peter Mumford. I'm Director and Designer of the Ring Cycle for Opera North, and that's about it.
How does it feel to now officially be an award winner for those efforts?
I think it's absolutely wonderful, and I'd like to say a big thank you on behalf of all of the people who've been involved in this whole process of creating this Ring Cycle for Opera North over the last 5-6 years. It's been wonderful, and thanks to all of them.
It's terrific that we are here celebrating, you know, really the enormous gamut of what arts and culture really means, and music what it really means in our country. And so it's absolutely, I think, a pivotal art form. I'd say that, wouldn't I? Because it embodies everything, music and text and drama and the thrill of all that. So, and of course, The Ring is one of the great pinnacles of achievement of any opera company, and to undertake it is a major undertaking, and to deliver it with the great vision of Peter here has been a fantastic experience. I think opera, you know, is a sort of consummate art form, and I think the fortunate part about opera is that it embodies fantastic drama, fantastic text, fantastic music, which can be very inspiring. I think the real challenge for opera is how to present it and engage audiences, particularly younger audiences, in that art form, and maybe it's breaking out of the traditional way that we perform it necessarily in a theatre, on a stage, and taking it into new genres, into the whole digital world, and it is, I believe, one of the most accessible art forms if we get that bit right.
How proud are you to have presented the award, not just for this category, but for this remarkable piece of television?
Oh, really proud. I mean, all three nominees are, you know, in the drama category are outstanding beyond belief. And yes, I'm very honoured to be just presenting to any of the nominees. But Happy Valley really has, you know, taken to people's hearts, and it really has struck a chord with people. And, you know, Sally's writing is, as we know, incredible, and you know, it's really authentic, and it has such a heart to it. And I think that's what people really connect with. And I did a radio play of Sally's, actually, about the Bronte sisters many moons ago, but we've never met, so it was lovely to actually get to meet her in person. I think it's a lot of it's to do with timing, that a show comes at the right time when people are wanting it, when people are needing it. You know, sort of like a show like Downton is a very different show to Happy Valley, but both struck a chord with audiences, I guess, because ultimately you believe the characters and you invest in them and you care about them. And, you know, for a writer like Sally or Julian or whoever it may be, to be able to write characters that an audience connect with is the key. And that's what we ultimately fall in love with, I think.
About wanting more, audiences are still desperate for more Downton, and Julian keeps teasing us that the film is going to happen or might be happening. Do you have any updates for that? Where do you stand at the moment? Is the film happening? Is it not happening? Have you seen the script?
Well, Julian keeps teasing all of us with this information, because we have no idea, is the honest answer. We've sort of like, they keep thinking, oh, maybe we do have an idea. Then we're like, no, we don't have any idea. I really don't know. You know, I think all the cast are, you know, up for doing it, and we're all sort of, you know, we'd all be very happy to pop back and have a little reunion and do a little 10 weeks together. But, you know, ultimately it's out of our hands. There's not a lot we can do or say about it. So no information here, unfortunately.
We're just happy. It's nice. A self-spank show is very special, because it's not just telly. It's the bigger, broader picture of the arts, and that's very important. And as I said earlier, it's important to me personally. The South Bank show has always been very important to me since I was a teenager. I've watched it on telly since I was a teenager, when the arts was a distant thing that was happening a long way away from where I was. So to be winning this now is very special.
You think that's something that's changing the concept that arts is far away and hard to reach?
Yeah, it is changing all the time, I hope. But it's still a long journey to go for a lot of people. If you live in London, it's not so hard. If you live in the north, it's different.
What is it about Sally's writing that is so special and so important, do you think?
No pressure.
I think what it is when Sally writes a scene, it goes in a direction you don't expect. She sets up psychologies and temperaments and personalities that they never quite run along well-oiled tracks. They go their own way, like people do. So when you get a script and you turn the pages, the character never goes in the way you think it will. That's what makes it really great to do, great to play.
And of course, fans are so desperate to get more. Sally said that she's not quite started writing it, but we are hopefully going to get a third portion of Happy Valley. What are you most excited about, getting the chance to, at some point, hopefully, continue this story?
I want to see what happens to that little boy. That's what I want to see.
I just want to know what happens with the relationships. I think it's there's a lot of love there, you know? There's a lot of capacity for love and happiness, and with this ominous presence that's always on the periphery. So I'm just intrigued by the characters, you know? That's it.
To be in it, that'd be nice. If she hadn't started writing it yet, then if I can just put that out there, I hope I'm back. That'd be really good. Yeah, I'll go and mention it. I'll mention it now, actually.